Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. It is me, Robbie993, and we are doing floors, 31 to 40 this episode? Sure, yeah, that sounds about right. So, last episode, Great Fairy said we had to have the power to move statues before we could continue any further. I'm just dominating these BMOs, oh my goodness. This one's always hard to hit, though, because it's kind of in a weird position. Okay, Link, can we rearrange ourselves with the bow and arrow? That was in a good way. No, I still can't see where his eye is. Okay, that's better. There we go. Sweet. All the BMOs are dead. And now I have to deal with the keys. Excellent. Did I say that the Great Fairy said we had to use the ability to move lifeless statues in order to proceed? I hope so. That's what I meant to say. Anyways, let's move them off the switches. You don't have to move them into any fancy place, but just off the switches is good enough. So let me just re-equip my bow, because that's more important than the thing. Actually, let's re-equip, not re-equip, but let's equip my claw shots, because claw shots are a wonderful way of removing enemies from the ceiling without using arrows. Like, arrows would easily kill these guys too, but of course you want to preserve your arrows. So killing them with claw shot works really well too, and it should actually reach those. Not entirely sure why it's not. Can we kill the slugs? There we go. They will fall off too, if, like, when you go down there, they'll fall from the ceiling so you can kill them as well, but you know, it's always fun to kill them while they're up here. So it looks like we got fire keys and bubbles, woo, bubble. Hey, come up here, I dare you. I double dog dare you, that sounds so lame, but that was one of the ones in school, yes, they used to say. I double fudge dare you, might be another one. Let's see if we can try to bring some of them up here before we take on the geckos and stuff. Okay, well I killed one. Can we kill others? Maybe. Pick up some others? I think I'm gonna miss all these completely. Oh, I got a couple! Oh, sweet! I got two! Okay. I don't think it will bring bubbles up, but it will bring keys up. So, that's always a good thing, to kind of get rid of them. Awesome, I got two more! So, I think that could be good, actually. That might be alright. I think the rest of them are bubbles anyways. Someone's coming close to me. Let's just go with it. So we'll have our arrows actually set out first because that will kill the... That will kill the Dodongos, so... Ah! Wonderful. Spin attack. Oh, the Dodongos are all over there anyway, so they're not a big threat. Just, yeah, the combinations of enemies can be overwhelming sometimes. So if you can try to get rid of some of them at least before you hop your way down, it's always a good way to ensure you'll remain with life and be able to kill them all. Okay, so that's one gecko, and the other. Sweet! Everything's dead! And yes, this is where definitely floors become more difficult. We're getting to the, we're over halfway done, and we are at the last 20 floors. So we got to get serious now. What do we got here? Oh my god, we have so many re-deads. And do we just have four, though, or is there six? I think there's just four, and then there's one Poe. So again, we'll bring out the ball and chain because it works marvelously, and we'll fall off the edge here. The Poe won't see us if we stay on the edge. And thankfully the ball and chain doesn't like antagonize him or anything. But as long as we stay way over here, we can get the re-deads with the ball and chain. Ugh. And the Poe won't bother us. I think I'm just going to run around to this other side because then the Poe is closer to the back than he is to the front. He's not quite center. And at least kill three of the re-deads so that they don't get on your case. And then transform into a wolf. And just guide the Poe over to you. Hello, Poe. I think Poe is a Teletubby, is it not? I believe it is. It's really... I did watch Teletubbies as a kid. That was one of those shows that was on. Oh my god, the re-dead is coming! The re-dead is coming! And actually, I remember the vacuum cleaner used to clean up their, was it like tubby pudding or something like that? Like they made like these pink pancake things out of this, I don't know, it was like their tubby pancakes or something, I don't remember. But, and then their vacuum cleaner was new, and it would clean up all the spills. And when I was a kid, I would, like, clean up people's leftovers off, like, my parents' plates or my siblings' plates, because I was an eater. I loved to eat. So my mom called me Nunu for a good portion of my childhood. But let's... Oh my god, chews. So many chews. Okay, well, let's just attack them as Wolflink. I think, actually, Wolflink... Oh, and there's ghoul rats, too. I was gonna say, I don't move very fast. There we go. Kill the ghoul rats. But I think Wolflink works fairly well against chews if he jumps in the right direction. I see a lot of times he's just jumping backwards like an idiot. Kill the ghoul rat. And kill the chew. Kill it. Oh yeah, he works really well against those. Sorry, I was quiet. Again, concentrating. Chews aren't usually a big deal, but if you can get like a whole bunch of chews, it can be kind of overwhelming again. Okie dokie. Let's actually transform back into a human. Ah, Teletubbies. That was a weird show. There's rabbits all over the hills. Oh, there's a Freezard. Okay, so let's try to get some of these keys up here, because that Freezard can reach us no matter where we're at down there. So let's just make a bunch of spots. But there's rabbits all over the hills, and I think at the end of like each episode when they were supposed to go home, there was like these megaphones that would like rise out of the ground, and it would be like time for Tubby bedtime or something, I think is what it said. And like the sun had a baby's face and just giggled constantly. Like, actually kind of scary. I got nothing that time. I think two keys are probably all right. I think I got that one though. Let's just remove. Ah, that should be good after this. Let's see. Okay, let's bring the ball and chain out because that's what's going to take down the Freezard. And let's just run around behind him. And kill him before anybody touches me. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, I'm doing so well. Oh my gosh, he froze me in my practice when I practiced this place. Can I reach you? Oh, I did. Sweet. Come to me, mini Freezards. Attack me. And I'll bless you. Oh my god, the other one's like, nope, you killed my friend. I ain't. Okay, no, now he wants revenge. That's fine, I suppose. Yeah, Teletubbies. Why am I talking about Teletubbies for? What was another weird, like, little kid show that I used to watch? The other day, someone brought up, like, the show Madeline on Reddit or something like that. And I remember watching it, but heaven forbid, I don't actually remember, like, any storylines. Anyway, it's just spam bomb arrows to kill these things. I am not going to tackle with multiple ones. Oops. I don't even care if I'm wasting arrows. Their arrows well spent, my opinion. I can take one, though. Aha! Death. Yeah, one's fine, but the other ones I will happily get rid of. I think there's only a couple floors that have a lot of chill foes in them. I think there's actually only one more floor that has chill foes. Okay, what's in this room? Just bubbles, is it? Seems suspiciously easy. Oh, levers too. Oh, that should kill a lot of things. Should kill levers at least. Ah, the levers are easy the few times that they appear in here because you just have to wait for them to get really close to you and then you can unleash a great spin and it'll just take them all out. Is there any... I don't even know. I've lost complete track of where there are extra goodies. I suggest just checking every room. Okay, here's the other chillful room. And I think there's four of them. Sometimes it can be hard because, like, the explosion of the bomb. This Bubble's gonna come touch me, isn't he? Bubble, either touch me or go away. They will sometimes get over this ledge, but a lot of times they just, like, kind of stop. There you are. Okay, come here. Now I try attacking them behind them so they fall towards the stairs. That way I can kill them before they can regrow their wings. But that's the strategy I use, so I don't know if it's good or not. Okay, for Chillfoes, my suggestion is when you use bomb arrows to kill them, is kind of like bomb beside them so that you fling them back in a direction. That way you can see where they go after. So you can like hit them with the bomb arrow again, because they will move around like, whoa, what the hell was that? get away from the bomb arrow. Okay, can we put that away? Because I don't know where the other Chilfo is. Oh, we got another thing. Oh, I fell off. Oh, well. No big deal. I heated against my own advice. Okay, there's the other Chilfo. I think there's only four. There we go. Sweet. So he's dead. So you can hide under here. Bubble, don't touch me. And the Freezards won't get you. So that's kind of nice. I would kind of see if I can antagonize his keys. Come here, keys. Yeah, I don't think they can touch you from here. Actually, that should have been my opportunity to go get them. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get him to start sneezing. Because that's what it looks like he's doing. I'll just wait for him to stop. Okay, good. Let's go. And hit him before he sneezes again. And just, oh, bring it out. And just keep swinging. Kill them all. Excellent. Put that away. Let's get him to sneeze. Achoo! Let's face it, that's what he's doing. And then when he's done, smash him. Thankfully, yeah, the freezers aren't too difficult. Especially when they're off to the side like that, because then they can't hit you. Like, if it's in the middle, he can hit you in all directions. When they're off to the side, they cannot hit you. Like, if they're here and here, they can't hit you there and there, sort of deal. Okay, what's in this room? Ah! Oh, dark nuts! Okay. Okay, this is where things start to get difficult. Dark nuts. Let's see if I can just antagonize one. I've gotten better at fighting these, for all of you those who care to know. There we go, that's what you're supposed to do. When I was in the Temple of Time trying to do that, and it wouldn't work, that's what you're supposed to do. Oh, oops. I should have attacked him. Oh, too soon. There we go. Aha! So yeah, jump attacks work really well. Okay, don't antagonize the other one. Oh, I didn't. My thumb was off the joystick. My bad. It was my fault. Oh, sweet. I already got him to that stage. Oh, but I just pissed off the other one. Oh, no, he's still over there all fine and dandy. Okay, so maybe I can kill this guy. Lunge at me. Oops, I went the wrong way. Follow my orders. But I won't do what I plan to do. Oop. Oh, that was close. Ooh, silence there. Did you hear that? There's nothing. Oh, they had hit me. I don't think the other one's awake, though, yet. If this is good, I can keep this. Oh, I think it is pissed off. Maybe I can kill this one before the other one shows up. Or not, you know. Okay, okay. So the other one's here, too. That's not a big deal. Two of them. Actually, I had a hard time with two of them than I did with. I missed. Had a hard time with two of them than I did with, well, a later rendition of the Dark Nut levels, because there's more Dark Nuts. Guess what? Okay, just keep. Hope that other guy doesn't hit me. Actually, I kind of want to get rid of that other guy before this guy. Oh, jeez, really, sir? Really? One second. I just want to get the faster one before anything happens. Before I proceed with the other one. Okay, he's down. Okay, so now he's with this one. That's better. It's always nice to have one. Okay, sweet. Okay. Jump out of the way. He threw that really high, actually. Holy crap. And when they lunge at you, if you do a backslice around them just as they go to attack you, it works really well. So, like this. Lunge at me so I can show my viewers. Come on. Lunge. Attack. Attack. Please. Like that? So while he's doing his swing, he's totally off balance. And you can just stab him away. Again, spin attacks obviously weigh them down faster, which is really nice and such. So yeah, but I think actually that's the last enemy floor before the next great fairy. And it is. Ah, great fairy with wings. Like seriously, if you look at her wings are completely useless for actual flying. You know, they're just like plastic surgery to make her look more fancy. I am impressed that you made it this far, hero. In praise of your efforts thus far, I will release fairies till the neighbor's spring. From this point on, you will have need of the power that allows one to move freely from wall to wall. If you want to give up the fight for now and go re-equip yourself...
I don't want to read the entire thing. It's pretty much the same thing.
But okay. In the next episode, we will finish... We'll finish the Cave of Ordeals. I thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you then.